storage size, or storage performance. You don't have to choose anymore between size and performance. Azure Premium Files gives you both. I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy. If you want to master the Azure Cloud, you can start right now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss anything. One quick thing before we get started today is that I'm starting a new venture on top of the Azure Academy. This is with my good friend Christian Brinkhoff, and we are starting a video podcast series called Desktops in the Cloud, focusing on Windows Virtual Desktop. And there's our YouTube channel, so please go out there and subscribe to the channel. Be great if we could get to, 10,000 subscribers by next week. That'd be awesome. And let me play a quick intro for you.
Hi there, friends, and welcome to the first unofficial episode of Desktops in the Cloud, your new technical-driven video podcast with guest speakers from Microsoft Engineering and as well the worldwide virtual desktop communities. And I'm not doing this alone. I'm teaming up here with my good friend Dean Cifola from the Azure Academy series.
And with many people increasingly working from home and all the new developments around Windows Virtual Desktop, we'll keep you up to date with all the latest updates, best practices, and more. Please follow us on our social channels on YouTube, Spotify, Twitter, LinkedIn, and our website, desktopsinthecloud.com.
And what better way to start with Ken Verbrett, the Group PM Leader of the Windows Virtual Desktop team. So stay tuned as we will release this episode very shortly from now.
So that's going to be a pretty cool thing, and I think you'll get some enjoyment out of that if you're following Windows Virtual Desktop at all. So with that, let's get back to today's topic. Azure Files is a fully managed file share that lives in the cloud. It's highly scalable in size and performance, can be very easily backed up with the push of a button, and can be accessible anywhere in the world. And you can build it in just seconds. So here's the plan for Premium Files. We're going to first build ourselves a Premium Files share, and I'll explain all of the performance and ins and outs of all that. Then we're going to protect our Premium Files share. And then finally, I'm going to show you ways that we can use Premium Files. And for a bonus feature, you're going to want to stick with us right to the end of today's video because there's an announcement that just came out that's really going to enhance how you use Premium Files. You don't want to miss that. Let's get into it. Over in the Azure portal, I've got a resource group set up for today, and at the top, we'll just click Add. And then at the very bottom of that list, we'll choose a storage account. I'll call my storage account MSAA Premium File 00. And once you've put in your name, select your region. I'll go with East US, and we'll scroll down a little bit. Now here's where we choose between standard and premium files. So what is the big difference between the two? Well, the main difference, of course, is performance, and that's because standard file accounts are built on hard drives. Now, hard drives have always been great for capacity. You get far more size, but the performance is not as good, especially by today's standards. So while standard files is built on hard drives, premium files is built exclusively on SSDs. Now remember I said in the intro that you don't have to choose between size and performance, and that's because you can get the same amount of storage size out of your file share, up to 100 terabytes as of today. The performance and throughput that you can get in premium files is 10 times greater than what you can get in standard, as you can see from this chart from the Azure documentation, which is linked in the description below. So today I'll be choosing a premium files account, and then we have to choose our account kind, and we'll be choosing file storage. And when you do, the other thing to keep in mind for your storage is replication. Now, premium files is only available in locally redundant storage and zone redundant storage. So if you need the storage itself to be resilient across zones, then choose ZRS. Otherwise, LRS is fine. So we'll hit next for networking. And this is where you have the choice to secure your storage account and lock it down using a private endpoint, also known as a Azure Private Link. And we have done a video on that, and we'll link that up at the top so you can go check that out if you missed it. By default, all storage accounts are open to all networks, or you could choose to set it to a selected network, or you can go with the full private endpoint like we talked about in the video. So for today, I'm just going to use the public endpoint. And we'll hit next for data protection. Now, a lot of these options are grayed out because they're related to blob storage, but the one that we can take advantage of is soft delete for Azure Files, which I'll turn on and enable for 7 days. And we've covered all these features in a previous video on storage data protection, which I'll link at the top. You can go check that out. And we'll click next. And the only thing that I want you to make sure you have enabled is that secure transfer is set to enabled. We'll hit next and add our tags. And once you're done with that, go ahead and hit the review and create button. Now, while that's provisioning back in our resource group, I'm going to add another resource. And I'll search for backup and site recovery. This is Azure Backup. We'll hit create for this. There's a direct integration of Azure Files into Azure Backup. And I'll give it a name of Premium Backup in the East US region. Hit next for my tags. And when you're ready, go ahead and create. Now that all that has finished creating, let's go into our storage account. And you can see we've got just a file share as an option. Let's click file shares and we'll create ourselves a new file share. And then we have our provisioned capacity. And this is how much space we want. And based on the size of the share that we provision, we will get a certain amount of performance. This is also shown as a table inside the Azure Docs, which again is linked in the description down below. And the more space you give it, the more performant it will be. I want to have 30,000 IOPS, I need to provision 30 terabytes of storage. So I'll hit create and the share is created just that fast. Now back in the share, if I go to properties and then try to go to Azure Backup, we can set up from here directly our backup policy and start to protect our file shares. And notice that it's already selected my premium backup vault because they're in the same region. I'm gonna create a new file backup policy. And I'm gonna create multiple restore points here, one every 7 days, 3 weeks, 14 months, and 10 years. And you can do whatever it is that suits your environment. I'll hit okay, then we'll click to enable backup. And our setup has completed. And let's look at our recovery services vault and backups. And we have one backup item. We click on that and it shows an Azure storage account. And there is our file share. Let's get into some use cases. The very straightforward one, of course, is that you can just go into your file share and at the top you can click connect and then you set whatever drive letter you like. I'll go with the P drive for premium files. Click copy, open the PowerShell ISE, drop your code in there and run that code. It will test and make sure that you can reach the storage and then it will map the drive for you. And then we can just open up our Windows Explorer and there is our share at 30 terabytes. Then I'll just copy some files in from another file share that I have. Then we can jump back to the Azure portal, click the refresh, and there's all of the files. So a direct way to mount the file share. And that's great for one computer, but we want to make this usable by more systems at the same time. Back in the Azure storage account, on the left, we'll go to configuration. And at the very bottom here, we want to enable Active Directory Domain Services Authentication. We have done a video on that already, so you can click that if you haven't seen that one yet. And I've updated the code for all of my variables. And after you've run the first half of the code to get everything set up, we can then run lines 26 through 30, and that'll do the storage account join. And in about a minute or so, that will complete, and then you can verify that everything's working by running the debug command at the end. And all of our health checks are passed. We've successfully joined our storage account to our domain. Now we just need to test it. And I'm logged in now with the user Nova and we've got the Windows File Explorer. And I'll just paste in the UNC and we've got instant access. So everything is working from the AD side and I'll create a test folder. And then we can just verify that inside our share and there is the Nova test folder. So this can be used now as a standard file share across anywhere in your Active Directory for regular file shares, scale out file servers, for Windows Virtual Desktop, and more. Now that we've got our premium share set up, let's work on our cluster. And this would be a good point for me to remind you that if you haven't yet subscribed to the Azure Academy, go ahead and click that button, join us here at our community, and click that thumbs up if you're enjoying our content. Now, if you've seen our recent video on shared disks in Azure, we already provisioned a cluster using a graphical method. And this time we're going to do it with PowerShell, but first we need virtual machines. But that also means that we want these virtual machines to be as close to each other and to our storage as possible, which means first we want a proximity placement group. So we'll search for that in the marketplace and then click to create it. And we'll give it a name of SQL-PPG and next and add our tags. And then go ahead and create it. And now we're ready to build our virtual machines. So we'll go back to the marketplace. We'll search for Azure SQL and then hit create. This will give us the options for building out SQL in all its forms from the PaaS service to SQL managed instance to a SQL virtual machine. And if you're interested in us starting a series on SQL or any other data services, give me some comments down below and we'll take care of getting that started. But I'm just going to use the free license for today and hit create. So the name of our server is SQL-0. I'm building that inside an availability set. We'll just be using a premium disk for the operating system, and this will be built on my existing virtual network. But on the advanced screen, don't forget to add your proximity placement group, because just like the availability set, you've got to do that at the build time. Next is the SQL server settings. This is actually going to represent our SQL installation in Azure. I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time on this today because this video is more about premium files. I'm going to use a standard SQL port of 1433 with SQL authentication turned on. Then we'll scroll down a little bit and we have the disk configuration. So I'll click change here to show you what I'm doing. And here I've chosen to deploy a 8 gig disk as the smallest disk that I could deploy for this type of solution, since I have the logs also being stored where the data disk is. We'll click next and add our tags, then we'll hit review and create. And because I want two servers in my cluster, I'll go ahead and repeat that whole process in the background. And I've opened up the PowerShell ISE and copied in the connection code from the Premium File Share. And I'm also going to create a directory called SQL Test just to make sure I can write to it. And we got our map drive going out to the SQL cluster. And there's our SQL test folder. And just repeat that on the other VMs in your cluster before you continue with the next step. Now, the rest of this code I've gotten out of the Azure documentation, which is linked below in the description area. And this is what's going to actually set up our cluster. So the first thing, we need to install all the cluster features. And I'll do that on both VMs from the same PowerShell console. And then we're ready to start doing our cluster. So let's run the test against the cluster and see if everything is ready to go. And our validation report shows one warning on the network side, and that is that we have a single network card inside our VMs, which, as we covered in our last cluster video, not a problem in Azure. We can ignore that issue. So we are ready to go. Now, how you set up the new cluster is going to depend on what operating system you have. Do you have a load balancer, or are you using the dynamic network name? So for a load balancer configuration, your management point network type should be singleton. If you're using a DNN, then you can set it to distributed, or you can just leave it to automatic. Server 2019 will default to distributed, so whatever works for you. I'll set mine to automatic and go ahead and run the new cluster build. And if we go back to the failover cluster manager, and we click to connect to the cluster, and we say cluster on this server, and hit OK. We've got a failover cluster ready to go. And now we need to set up our quorum that we're going to use. So I'll right click on the cluster, go to more actions, and then configure cluster quorum settings. We'll click next and then select the quorum witness. Select next, and then you can choose from a disk, file, or cloud witness, and I'll choose cloud. Now we need the name of our storage account. And back in Azure, I'm going to pull this storage account that I had in a shared resource group, paste that in, and now we need the storage account key. And that's over here on the access keys on the left. You can grab either access key and just paste it into the wizard. Then we hit next, let that finish. And now we have our cloud witness. So on the C drive, you'll find your SQL Server install, and we're going to run setup. And about in the middle, you'll find the new SQL Server cluster installation, and that's what we'll click on. And we'll be going with the free version in this case. And I've just clicked next through the wizard and taken all the defaults up till this point where we want to set up the database engine configuration. This is where Premium Files comes in. You want to take the data root, user, user log, and backup directories and put them all on Premium File Storage. So I'll paste in the path to get to the Premium File Storage, then hit next. So I'll hit OK and hit next. And then we're ready to install our cluster. So the cluster setup is complete. We've got both nodes added into the cluster. SQL 2 here actually owns the cluster at this point, which you can see up here at the top, the current host server. And if we look over at the roles, there is the SQL cluster and all of the resources related to the cluster. But out in the file share, we've got the folder structure for all of our databases, logs, jobs, etc. And here I've opened up the SQL Management Studio just for a quick example. And there's all of our basic built-in databases. I'll go to right-click and add a new database. And we'll just give it a name of Premium Files and hit OK. And there's our new database over on the left. And going out to Azure Files into the data folder, there are our premium database and log files. And we'll just write a simple query here. And this will create a couple tables for us and then populate them all with data. Over on the tables, now we've got our analytics, Azure Academy, and contributors table. Now you can just proceed to use the cluster as normal and know that if you need extra horsepower under the hood, you can always increase the amount of storage available through premium files, which will then boost you according to however many IOPS you allocate. So the bonus feature that I wanted to talk about today is that SMB Multi-Channel is now enabled for your premium files storage account. Here is the announcement blog, and I'll have this linked in the video description. With SMB Multi-Channel, now you can get more connections from a single server. So if you think about this for file services or FS Logics and Windows Virtual Desktop, getting multiple connections from a single VM into storage to be able to increase your throughput over that multi-channel connection really will pick up your performance and take advantage of all of those higher IOPS that are available. We need a special URL to get there, and that is aka.ms/smb-multi-channel-preview. And that'll just enable this feature in your browser. And now you can see we've got Active Directory, Soft Elite, and SMB Multi-Channel. All we have to do to enable it is just flip the switch and hit save. So give me some comments down below on how you're going to take advantage of Azure Files. And I hope you've enjoyed taking this quick look at this great service and the multiple ways that we can get it implemented and locked down and secured so you can get as much storage size and storage performance as you need. So if you liked our video today or learned something new, go ahead and smash the like button. That lets me know that you appreciate our content. It also helps us out with the YouTube algorithm. And the more people who like and subscribe to the videos and to the channel, of course, boosts us overall, which is a big help to us. And then we can help out more people at the same time. And we are here to help you. So give us some questions below or comments on what you would like us to make for our next video. And if you're looking for something additional, you can watch our latest video over here on the top right, or one that we've had our masters over at YouTube pick out for you so that you can keep on learning about Azure. Thanks very much for joining us, and we will catch you in our next video. Happy learning.